wholly foreign-owned enterprises, equity joint venture, and cooperative joint venture. In the past, if a foreign private equity would like to set up a partnership in China, it had to set up a WFOE or EGV at first, and then make the WFOE or EGV invest a partnership. Now, from March the 1st, 2010, foreign investors are allowed to set up a foreign invested partnership directly with other foreign investors or domestic investors. Foreign company, foreign individual are only allowed to invest convertible foreign currency or renminbi as paid-in capital. There are no registered capital requirements and capital verification requirement for FIP. FIP is not a CIT payer. Its income shall be regarded as its partner's income. It makes FIP a very tax-efficient way for PE and trust funds. Here is a comparison of tax effectiveness of the three investment structures. You may find the net income of A and B would be 150 in scenario three, which is much more tax efficient than that in scenario one and scenario two. In part three, we are going to talk about some tax incentives available. Under the new CIT regime, tax incentives are transformed from regional-focused to industry-focused. With the ever-increasing concerns on the imbalance of regional development and economic structure, China tax regime is tend to encourage the certain types of enterprise and projects instead of certain special areas such as Shenzhen, Shanghai, Pudong, etc. I'd like to give some examples to make you aware of the tax incentives available. For example, for high and new technology enterprise, 15% of tax rate rather than 25% is available under reapplication every 3 years. For the technology advanced service enterprise, a 15% tax rate will be available until 2013. BT exemption for offshore outsourcing is also available. For the software enterprises, a 2-year exemption and then 3-year half CIT treatment will be granted from the first profit-generating year. For agriculture, the forestry, animal husbandry, or fishery, CIT is exempt or held. For public infrastructure in environmental protection and energy or water conservation, the tax holiday of 3 years exemption and 3 years half is applicable. Apart from those tax incentives, there is still a regional tax holiday for the West China in China tax regimes. The West China includes 12 provinces, and accounts for around 70% of China's land, near 30% of population, but only 18% of the total GDP of China. So the policymaker is intending to rebalance the regional development by performing a second 10-year wise development scheme from 2011 to 2020. The preferential tax treatment for the wise development would be 15% CIT rate for encouraged FIE, 2-year exemption and 3-year half of CIT for transportation, electronic power, water conservation, post-broadcast projects. Custom duty exemption for import of equipment for encouraged projects and other local incentives. If a foreign investor is looking for a place to settle its Asia Pacific headquarters, or East Asia headquarters, or Greater China headquarters, or only China headquarters, it may need to consider the local incentives in the prospective cities for the regional headquarters, because the local incentive may be very attractive and require different criteria to apply. In general, the local governments have not been authorized to create tax reduction or exemption, so they will provide the following policies. One-off bonus for set up or settle in, rental subsidy, refund of paid taxes, rewards to individual talents, simplify entry and exit procedures for foreigners. China tax regime also encourages all the enterprises to perform R&D activities. For the R&D expenses incurred for the encouraged industries, the R&D expenses can be deducted before tax with an additional 50%. Such R&D expenses include design and formulation fees, materials and power supplies, etc. Since the China tax regime has been changed, you may want to consider the tax implications for corporate reorganization. From the corporate income tax perspectives, the corporate reorganization include change of legal form, debt restructuring, share acquisition, assets acquisition, merger, demerger. Basically, the CIT treatment in relation to the corporate reorganization could be classified to two: ordinary CIT treatment and special CIT treatment. Under the ordinary CIT treatment, income or loss on transfer of equity or assets should be recognized at fair value at the time of transfer. The tax base of equity or assets should be restated at fair value at the time of transfer. While under special CIT treatment, for the assets corresponding to non-equity consideration, the tax treatment is similar to that under ordinary